Hi there, everyone. How's it going? Today, I just need to come forward and confess that these are the games I cannot beat. I've played them. I've come back to some of my old games and beaten them from my childhood and done the whole sort of, you know, victory lap thing. But there's some games I refuse to finish. I refuse to beat. And it's not that I'm walking away from them because they're bad and I don't like them. These are games that I genuinely like, I was enjoying, and were good, but are too difficult for me to actually beat. So I'm going to just lay it out there and I'll let you guys decide if it's justified or not. So first up is F-Zero GX. I mean, there's another one, copy past it, but you know how hard this freaking game is, how rage inducing it is, and especially that one time bomb mission. I thought, okay, once I beat that, I'll be able to beat the game, I'll get through it, whatever. And beating Black Bull or whatever, or Blood Falcon or whatever the second last boss was, I'm like, okay, that was really hard, that was a great challenge, I'm good. And then I'm like, the game's over, right? It's like, nope, apparently you have to race like the god of F-Zero, the god of the tracks in this spiritual plane of pseudo Rainbow Road. But unlike Mario Kart, if you fall off the track, like, the race is over. It is donezo. You have to start from the very beginning. There's no Laputa to pick you up and put you down. The race is over, and worse than Rainbow Road, there are no barriers on this track, and you're going a bajillion miles an hour. And I thought, I could do this. It would take me a week, maybe two, to like memorize all the inputs, but I'm just not going to do it. This is ridiculously, stupidly difficult. This is one of the first times I remember, I'm good. I played like 99% of this game, but this is actually something where I'd have put in so much time, it would be stupid. So I had to walk away from this one, and I mean, there it is, yeah. I beat the game in my mind because, like, I don't need to see the last cutscene or whatever. I did enough that I was satisfied with it, so yeah. Ninja Gaiden. Ninja effin' Gaiden. I might come back to this game since I did a review of it recently, and I'm just curious to see how hard it is. But Ninja Gaiden, I know Dark Souls say it's the hardest game. No, Ninja Gaiden is the hardest game ever made. Just like Ninja Gaiden Black specifically, just flat out. Because you know what you have to do. You know what to do. You just need to do it. And it's just really difficult. And so I remember going through this game thinking, am I just bad? Do I suck? Is this game supposed to be this hard? Am I playing on the wrong difficulty? Is it like on, like, what is going on here? And I was able to like push myself through the game, figure out, okay, I'm going to use this one decapitation method that kind of always works. And like, you're a ninja going up against guys with like tanks and armor and guns. It's like you're a real, it's ridiculous. It's stupid. And for a while, I was like farming some kind of animal or creature to get like points to upgrade my sword in hopes that I could like, you know, do more damage. Because seriously, I was just like, I was at a loss. I was like, why am I taking so much damage? This is ridiculous. I've never seen a game over screen so many times in my life. And so basically, I was able to get to the Alma fight, and somehow I beat Alma by pushing me like myself to the limit. And then after that, I just thought, look, I just don't want to play this game anymore. I do not care about the aesthetic of this Egyptian kind of crypt level. I don't care about the story. I don't care about anything. I don't care about anything enough to keep playing, where it is so punishingly difficult. But yeah, I beat the mid-boss of this game, and I was like, okay, I am satisfied. I'm walking away. That's it. Bye-bye. And I'm proud of myself that I at least beat this boss. But after that, I was like, that's it. I'm literally done. Yeah. It's funny. When I started Genocide Route, I thought, oh, it's going to be like pretty much the same. But no, it was very different. Like, I was surprised by the Undine boss fight was completely revamped, a totally new thing. I was super, it took me a couple hours to do Undine. So I was like, oh, geez, this is going to be really painful for the rest of the game. I don't know how far I get. And I got to Metatron. I thought, oh god, this is going to be even worse. And to my surprise, that was a nothing fight. I can't believe Toby made an entirely new song just for that fight, and you kill him in one hit. Like, I was honestly shocked. I was like, oh no, if Metatron was that easy, then this guy is going to be super hard. And when I realized just how hard he was and the fact that Sans will actually count how many times you've actually fought him, I was just like, I've beaten the end boss of Drakengard 3. I know what it is, what it means to put in time to beat a ridiculously stupid fight. And I just knew from this boss fight that I would have to basically develop muscle memory in order to beat this boss. Sans is stupidly, ridiculously hard. With all the giant lasers and everything, I just knew that the only way to beat him is to get stupidly good at it, and again, get that muscle memory down to even have a chance of doing it. And I was like, I am not, that is not worth it to me. I'm not going to spend like a week or however long it takes of muscle memory to like beat this guy. I am fine. And so I walked away, and yeah, never beat Genocide. Oh no, terrible. And this is the final one. Mega Man games have always been hard, and the only one I've really played is Mega Man X. I was so proud of myself when I was able to beat all 8 bosses and whatever, and do the final level, and I got like halfway. But then there's that one platforming section with all like, the platforms that are hovering in the air. And I just kept failing that over and over and over again. And then I realized, oh, I'm going to have to fight or refight all the bosses that I just beat in this one level. And I thought, that is not enjoyable at all. I don't care how this game ends. I don't want to fight Sigma. I don't need to fight Sigma. I don't care how much gear they give me. I don't want to do it. And so I just had to basically walk away. This is the game where it became so hard it was not fun anymore. Anyway, guys, those are the games I just refuse to beat. I mean, I'm sure if I put in the time and effort, I could probably do them. But these are the ones where I played it up until, again, the very end. And I thought, this is no longer worth it. I don't really want to do it anymore. And so I just backed out. Will I come back to them someday? Maybe, but really, who cares, right? All right, that's it for this video. Bye, guys.